Let's do some more percentage problems. Let's say that I start this year in my stock portfolio with $95. And I say that my portfolio grows by, let's say, 15%. How much do I have now? Have now. Okay, I think you might be able to figure this out on your own, but of course we'll do some example problems just in case it's a little confusing. So I'm starting with $95, and I'll get rid of the dollar sign. We know we're working with dollars. $95, right? And I'm going to earn, or I'm going to grow, just because I was an excellent stock investor. That $95 is going to grow by 15%. So to that $95, I'm going to add another 15% of 95. So we know we write 15% as a decimal, as 0.15. So 95 plus 0.15 of 95, so this times 95. That dot is just a time sign. It's not a decimal. It's a times. It's a little higher than a decimal. So 95 plus 0.15 times 95 is what we have now, right? Because we started with $95, and then we made another 15% times what we started with. Hopefully that makes sense. Another way we say it, the $95 has grown by 15%. So let's just work this out. This is the same thing as 95 plus, well, what's 0.15 times 95? Let's see. So let me do, hopefully I have enough space here. 95 times 0.15. I don't want to run out of space. Actually, let me do it up here. I think I'm about to run out of space. 95 times 0.15. 5 times 5 is 25. 9 times 5 is 45. Plus 2 is 47. 1 times 95 is 95. Bring down the 5. 12, carry the 1, 15. And how many decimals do we have? 1, 2, 15.25. Is that right? I think I made a mistake here. See, 5 times 5 is 25. 5 times 9 is 45, plus 2 is 47. And we bring a 0 here. That's 95, right? 1 times 5, 1 times 9. And then we add 5 plus 0 is 5, 7 plus 5 is 12. Oh, see, I made a mistake. It's 14.25, not 15.25. So I'll ask you an interesting question. How did I know that 15.25 was a mistake? Well, I did a reality check. I said, well, I know in my head that 15% of 100 is 15. So 15% of 100 is 15. How can 15% of 95 be more than 15? I think that might have made sense. The bottom line is 95 is less than 100. So 15% of 95 had to be less than 15. So I knew my answer, 15.25, was wrong. And so it turns out that I actually made an addition error, and the answer is 14.25. So the answer is going to be 95 plus 15% of 95, which is the same thing as 95 plus 14.25. So 95 plus 14.25, well, that equals what, 109.25. Notice how easy I made this for you to read, especially this 2 here. 109.25. So if I start off with $95 and my portfolio grows, or the amount of money I have grows by 15%, I'll end up with $109.25. Let's do another problem. Let's say I start off with some amount of money, and after a year, let's say my portfolio grows 25%, and after growing 25%, I now have $100. How much did I originally have? Notice, I'm not saying that the $100 is growing by 25%. I'm saying that I start with some amount of money, it grows by 25%, and I end up with $100 after it grew by 25%. To solve this one, we might have to break out a little bit of algebra. So let x equal what I start with. What I start with. So just like the last problem, I start with x, and it grows by 25%. So x plus 25% of x is equal to 100. And we know this 25% of x we can just rewrite as x plus 0.25 of x is equal to 100. And now actually we have a level, actually this might be a level 3 system, a level 3 a linear equation. But the bottom line, we could just add the coefficients on the x. So here x is the same thing as 1x, right? So 1x plus 0.25x, well that's just the same thing as 1 plus 0.25x. We're just doing the distributive property in reverse. Equals 100. And what's 1 plus 0.25? Yeah, it's easy. It's 1.25. So you say 1.25x is equal to 100. Not too hard. And after you do a lot of these problems, you're going to intuitively say, oh, if some number grows by 25% and it becomes 100, that means that 1.25 times that number is equal to 100. And if this doesn't make sense, sit and think about it a little bit. Maybe rewatch the video, and hopefully it'll over time start to make a lot of sense to you. And this type of math is very, very useful. I work at a hedge fund, and I'm doing this type of math in my head day and night. So 1.25 times x is equal to 100. So x would equal 100 divided by 1.25. I just realized you probably don't know what a hedge fund is. I invest in stocks for a living. Anyway, back to the math. So x is equal to 100 divided by 1.25. So let me make some space here, just because I used up too much space. Let me get rid of my little let x statement. Actually, I think we know what x is, and we know how we got to the there. If you forgot how we got there, you can, I guess, rewatch the video. Let's see. Now let me make the pen thin again and go back to the orange color. OK, x equals 100 divided by 1.25. So we say 1.25 goes into 100.00. I'm going to add a couple of zeros. I don't know how many I'm going to need. I probably added too many. If I move this decimal over 2 to the right, then I need to move this one over 2 to the right. Right? And I say, well, how many times is 100 going to 100? How many times does 125 go into 100? None. How many times does it go into 1,000? It goes into it 8 times. I happen to know that in my head, but you could do trial and error and think about it. 8 times, if you want to think about it, 8 times 100 is 800, and then 8 times 25 is 200, so it becomes 1,000. You could work it out if you like, but I think I'm running out of time, so I'm going to do this fast. 8 times 125 is 1,000. Remember, this thing isn't here. 1,000. So 1,000 minus 1,000 is 0. So you can bring down the 0. 125 goes into 0, 0 times. And we just keep getting zeros. This is just a decimal division problem. So it turns out that if your portfolio grew by 25% and you ended up with $100, you started with $80. And that makes sense. Because 25% is roughly 1/4, right? So if I start with $80 and I grow by 1/4, that means I grew by $20, because 25% of 80 is 20. So if I start with 80 and I grow by 20, that gets me to 100. Makes sense. So remember, all you have to say is, well, some number times 1.25, because I'm growing it by 25%, is equal to 100. Don't worry, if you're still confused, I'm going to add at least one more presentation on a couple of more examples like this.